never been gobbled. Drove the man to the grave. Where the men for a world with a Neanderthal world. And that's how he can raise him to the grave.
Hello! Welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews. Couple of special guests, special superstar guests. Now you may have seen me chatting to Anthony on the end there, and one day I'm sitting there chatting to him and he went, oh dude, he said, sorry, oh dude, they should come down to shut up, they should come down to brewery and stuff like that and get you to get me down here to up north and so. Then Maria, she got stuck in and she said, oh, dude, she's Hulk similar as well. Oh, dude, get thee down to the brewery and I come down and make thee tip Tetley's tea and stuff. To Yorkshire, tell me don't drink Tetley's down here. Anyway, sorry.
No, this actually, is going to be a long ass review.
She's an Essex girl.
I am an Essex girl.
In it, Minge.
In it and
right. Now we're going to behave because we're doing a proper, like, straight up beer review in it. We have got an Andwell Brewing Company Pilsner Hop. And this is dry hopped lager.
Ooh.
We got any idea what hops we got here, Ant?
Do you want me to read it since you haven't got your glasses?
No, it's a Czech style Pilsner, so I'd imagine something like Tetnangs and things, the noble hops.
Magnum.
We've got Czech Saz and
German
Saz and Tetnang, yeah. Two of the nobles.
And well, I'm sorry.
We don't know. We might really be legendary liking it. You know? So look out, because I'm going to open it and spoil it out. Ken's got a lovely little feel to it. Kind of like slightly rough. I like it rough. The cans, I mean, can you behave?
Never said a word.
Right, here we go. Maria's a bit shy. She's kind of gone, I'm a bit shy. She's a bit shy, so I just said, like, you know, imagine me in a nude and all that. Sorry, we'll get clump in a minute, I will. Right, so looking very straw-like and lovely and golden and beautiful. Big lady white head on the top, and I think we'll give it to Maria, she's the lady. Let you have a sniffed all, get your nose in amongst
ladies
that.
Ladies first.
Yes.
Ladies first, cheers.
Get your sniffer in there, girl, have a good swift. Well, and tell us what sort of things you're getting there. See, she said, so I've said that to my missus. With my extraordinary palate and the bugle is getting beer. But one point actually to make here, Maria was saying, I don't know about beer and all that. I always think you don't have to know about beer to be able to taste something. You've been tasting things all your life. See, I've got all serious now.
You have. Very businesslike.
I know.
Very businesslike.
Tasting things all your life, and everyone's got entitled to have an opinion about flavours and things. So before you go and get it all down, right?
Cheers.
Right. What sort of things?
Can take the girl out of Essex.
Go on, what sort of nice little flavours you got in there?
I've been drinking wine all night, so my palate is a bit inhibited, shall we say. I'm going to state the absolute obvious.
Yeah.
That it is very hoppy.
Good.
Which is what it's meant to be.
Yeah.
But I can't distinguish flavours, Terry.
But things like, is it nice and refreshing?
It is. It's hoppy, but it's light.
But not,
does that make sense?
Do you think it's nice as well?
It's not bitter. It's a nice... I could drink that.
Oh, good.
I could drink that.
Emily? Don't let her drink it off. I'll have a little go afterwards.
She can't drink my beers, but well done, Anwell.
Stick your bugle in there. Tell us about it.
I'm honest, I'm not getting that much of aroma off it.
No.
But it's a lager, so I won't expect it, he says.
Yeah.
Perhaps a bit of grapefruit coming off it.
Nice. I mean, we've got, as you said earlier, Saiz and Tech name in it.
Saiz, Terry.
Oh, it's called a Saiz.
It's got double A.
Saiz.
Saiz.
Saiz. You might say a different.
Yeah, get an orange off it.
Yeah.
But that's about it.
Anything malt-wise and things like that?
No. Like I say, it's just a bit of grapefruit, a bit of orange. It doesn't smell overly hoppy, is it?
Dive in there, bud.
Diving. That's actually really refreshing. Cool. It's not really got a massive bitterness on it, which, like I say, for a lager, you wouldn't expect it to.
Mm.
It's got a really, it's got like a sweet characteristic that I quite like. And it's not dry towards the end.
Yeah.
It's, I could drink quite a lot of that actually. Yeah,
nice.
I quite like that.
Nice.
It goes down easily.
Very easily.
Oh, it smells really gorgeous on the kind of the just nose straight away. It's like little lemony, little kind of piffs, lemon piffs. You're getting, like you say, the grapefruit in there. Little yellow grapefruit. A nice little wafer biscuits that you get with ice creams. Little hints of those. I like this, smells really clean. The malts are really just, the malts and the water, I don't know where the water would be with this. Would it be Pennine water or something?
I don't actually know where Andwell is.
Hampshire? Or Hampshire, I should say, Hampshire.
Hampshire.
Yes, Hampshire.
Hampshire.
But next to Surrey.
It smells really pure. It smells really lovely. But let's have a little taste. Oh, I like that. I like that. It's not kind of much to describe though, is it? There's little peppery notes on the finish. Like little, you know when you boil up, when you're cooking with celery.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, you get that celery sort of peppery note. Sorry, I'm spinning you. Got off in my tash. But you're getting little notes of that. Little white pepper notes in there on the finish. And just nice kind of like piffy but lemony little notes in there as well. I really like that. It's really clean and nice. And not clean in gauze clean. Clean tasting, in other words, taste of rice. Yeah. But that tastes nice. Sorry, I'm hogging this now. Yeah, I'm steaming. Yeah, I really like that. It's kind of nice little dryness to it, but as you say, it's not too dry where you kind of, you know, you're not looking forward to the next bit. You know, it's cutely done. I think people could drink a lot of that.
I was just
going to
say, you can keep going with that.
Yeah, you could drink a lot of that. And I've always been against putting lagers with curry. But I think that would actually go nice with a chicken tikka as well. Mm-hmm. And I used to go, no, lager with curry. Everyone always goes lager with curry, don't they? Oh, I've got a burp. I like that. Let's pour a bit more in before you drink it all. Do you want to drop my hand?
It'd be nice, thank
yeah,
you.
Wouldn't it? It's got all Maria's fillings in it.
Yep. A bit extra to chew on.
In it. She's going to go, she's all the London's been knocked out of her down here. She's kind of like started talking to up here, I should say.
Up north.
Started talking to like this and took like, you know. Now I've turned up and she's in it, geezer.
You're speaking like Danny Dyer.
Yeah, calling everyone minge and all that. It's not on, I'll tell you. I'm a bad influence. It's cute, isn't it? It's a nice one. I really like
it. It's very drinkable.
Mm, it is.
Yes.
And yeah, I have to say, Andy Weekend, who sent me it, thank you for that.
Yeah. So, bum 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 bum. Is it a try it, bite and like it?
I'd say for a lager, it's a try it, bite and love it. I haven't tasted many lagers that I drink again.
and brewed in Hampshire. What do you say?
I'd have it again.
Yeah, yeah.
Definitely.
And I would as well. I'd say try it, buy it and like it. I'd even try it, buy it and love it even. It's really lovely. It's not leaving gum in the mouth. It's just like, oh, get some more down.
Very drinkable.
Yeah, dangerous.
Yeah.
Yeah. It is dangerous, so watch yourselves. See you in the next one. Don't be late or we will start without you. See you all later. Biddly biddly boo.
Bye. With a man for a world.